Guys, today i-review natin isa sa pinaka highly anticipated no na gaming phone for 2022. And I know it's not the big brands like Asus, it's not the big brands like Red Magic, hindi rin siya from Lenovo, but this one is from Xiaomi. And hindi siya Black Shark. It's the Redmi K50 na gaming edition, no? And this is not your ordinary na gaming edition. This is the AMG Petronas na special edition, no? Samahan niyo ako, buksan natin. So hi guys, ako pa si Rich Bon ng Gadget Psychic and welcome back to my channel. So right now, nakaupo tayo sa ating noble chair, no? Na gaming chair. And right now, we're going to unbox this one. Lalaroin natin. Papakita ko sa inyo kung kano kaganda, no? And I'm sure at the end of this video, maglalaway kayo and sasabihin nyo, sana all. No? So this is a limited edition, guys. Remember, nabuksan natin ang K40 gaming edition na Bruce Lee. I think this is the same, okay? Na ano, no? Limited edition. Si Bruce Lee is one. Is to 4,000 lang, no? 4,000 units ang lumabas worldwide. I'm not quite sure yet. This one, kung ilan lang lumabas worldwide. This is with collaboration with Mercedes, no? AMG, Petronas, Formula One team. So, kita nyo, carbon fiber finish tong box na to. It's really nice. Collector's edition to, guys. So, kita natin, no? On the side, may kotse, no? And pagbukas natin, no? Kita natin, merong sleeve sa loob. Ang laman niya, no? Is a jelly case. As well as a documentation. Nothing else. Then, of course, further opening, makita nyo guys, magpa-pop up to. Oh, ay, astig. No? So, hawakan natin ang phone, no? And, na-unwrap natin to. Sabi ko sa guys, the experience is really nice. And this is the phone itself. It looks really nice. And we'll talk more about it in a while. And before that, meron pa tayo siyang secret drawer dito sa baba, no? So, paghila natin dito, pak, magnet to. Paghila nyo, makikita nyo, meron something. You know? So, it's the GaN charger na 120 watts of fast charging together with a USB Type-C cable. Okay? So, last year kay Bruce Lee, color yellow to. But this year, well, hindi nang ginawa. Sana ginawa ng green, no? Para medyo mas commemorative na edition, no? But anyways, masasabi ko sa'yo, this box is definitely a keepsake. Maganda siyang taguin. Ang ganda. Very limited. And of course, mahirap mabili. And probably the next question na itatanong niyo sa akin, no, saan pwedeng mabili tong phone na ito? And right now, I can say na pwede niyo mabili ito sa Shandy Philippines and sa Shandy Masangkay. I'll be posting their Facebook page on the description below. I'm not quite sure kung anong price mabibili niyo by then. But this is roughly near 40,000 pesos no, for this variant. And so, hawak na natin tong phone na ito. Fresh na fresh, it's really nice. And it really much resembles that of the Bruce Lee edition, no? So, itong gilid, ganun ang design, okay? Parang arrow in, no? Then, carbon fiber finish yung ilalim, no? Carbon fiber design, pero likod niya is made out of glass, no? Harap niya is Corning Gorilla Glass Victus. Aluminum metal frame to cap it off. Ganda, guys. Ang ganda ng feel na itong phone na ito, no? On my hands. And the best part is, of course, ang kanyang shoulder triggers, no? This is the best part, okay? Itong dalawang clicky-clicky na, ano, no? Physical shoulder triggers, no? Making it the probably one of the best, okay? Maybe not the best for you, but for me, it's the best. Kasi mentioned physical shoulder triggers, no? That makes me love the game more, mas immersed yung mga laro, no? Rather than air triggers. No, pag open natin, kita natin, no? Yung Mercedes na ano, wallpaper is definitely, woo, ganda. Parang jade green, no? Pag swipe up mo, kita nyo yung mga ano, no? Though yung mga icons niya are not specially made for this phone, but nevertheless, yung sabi ko sa inyo, well, yung ano, theme niya, no, is already good enough. I don't expect anything much, no, from yung mga icons, no, with Mercedes. I'm not quite sure, but overall, masasabi ko yung pagka-green niya is definitely very attractive, no, yung wallpaper niya out of the box. So right now, pag-usapan natin, no, yung mga ports, no, dito sa phone na ito. And start off natin sa ilalim, no. So sa ilalim, makita natin there is the loudspeaker, which looks really nice. So, hindi lang siya basta-basta limang butas. USB Type-C port, ang kanyang microphone in. And by the way, guys, it's powered together with JBL. And on the right side, kita natin, no? Ang kanyang shoulder triggers na physical. Okay, so kita natin magpa-pop out siya. Pop, pop, okay? Then, of course, power, kanyang power button, which is here. And the other shoulder trigger. Then sa ibabaw, kita natin is of course the other stereo speaker na okay, ganda ng design. Then of course, ang kanyang IR blaster together with the microphone. Then on the other side, kita natin, no, there's another microphone here, volume rocker, as well as yung kanyang SIM tray which can host two nano SIMs. And of course, ang kanyang triple camera setup na sa likod which starts with the 64MP main shooter. Ito, pinakamaganda is of course the AMG Petronas logo and ang kanyang carbon fiber finish ng likod. Carbon fiber lang yung design, no? But yung finish is glass finish na of course medyo fingerprint magnet din, no? Kahit papano along the way. So medyo magpupunas nga talaga kayo. So guys, this phone is powered by the Snapdragon 8 Gen 1. The latest and the greatest chip this year. 2020 para kay Qualcomm, no? Eh, masasabi ko sa inyo, guys, this phone definitely rocks. Ang ganda ng kanyang design. Nevertheless, almost kahawig niya si Bruce Lee, no, last year. And ang kanyang performance is definitely off the chart. Bigyan mo lahat ng mga kanyang multitasking. Grabe, guys. Wala ka-hiccups-hiccups tong phone na ito, no? Sobrang bilis. Blazing fast. I mean, gamit ko siya for 1 week to, and all I can say is, wow, a sobrang bilis na phone na ito. And probably the first thing na tatanong sa akin, no, is how to install Google Play Store. Now, of course, na-install ko na siya dito. I'll be making a quick tutorial on how to do this one in the other video. I'll be posting it on the link below para makita nyo, no. And mag-guide ko kayo kung paano nyo i-install ng maayos ang Google Play Store sa phone na ito. Now guys, itong phone na ito has a very nice screen. 6.67-inch na OLED display. 1 billion colors ang kaya niyang i-reproduce. And, guys, 120Hz of screen refresh rate. I wish na sana ginawa niya 144, no? And, of course, HDR10+. And Corning Gorilla Glass Victus ang kanyang protection up front. Making this phone very, almost crash-resistant, no? I'm not quite sure kung sinabak ni Jerry Riggs everything tong phone na ito, kung magsasurvive sa kanyang test. But Victus is definitely the best sa Corning Gorilla series, no, right now. So one thing na gusto ko dito, no, is meron siyang enhancement, no, super resolution, no, na pwede na enhance ang yung mga videos while you're watching here on this phone, no. Grabe. Not only that, may AI HDR enhancement pa. Plus may MEMC din to make the videos here a lot smoother than before. Lahat yan meron nandito sa K50 Gaming Edition. And of course, don't forget yung refresh rate niya, which can automatically be calibrated on its own, no, up to 120Hz. And of course, pag hindi mo kailangan bababa siya, up to 60Hz. So watching some videos here on YouTube, and of course, from Netflix, masasabi sa inyo, guys, it's really nice. Given na kanyang display can reproduce up to 1 billion colors, ang smooth sa mata, ang 120Hz of screen refresh rate, watching videos on this one definitely is very enjoyable. Kahit nasa under the bright sunlight ka, masasabi ko, guys, the display is really bright. And of course, I'm not quite sure kung ilang nits to, no? Kasi wala pa nakita sa spec sheet. But nevertheless, natry ko under the sunlight, it's still bright. Watching some videos here, guys, masasabi ko siya, the experience is really nice. Especially yung kanyang loudspeaker, no? Dito sa magkabila, no? JBL speakers, it's really nice. And guys, pakinggan nyo to, no, itong sound na ito while I'm playing some non-copyrighted music, no, here sa phone na ito, no. Ayo, Paris, this shit high, boy. Try to catch a vibe, yeah, I had to put her on. Bought a two-seater, yeah, we heading for the sun. Try to get my high, I ain't tripping for the funds. Yeah, I won't start, I ain't tripping, I'm a stunt. Oh, oh, living lively. Everybody trying to ride my wave, they can ride me. Been a foreign to the curve looking icy. I ain't never stress about a fit, I'm a hype. I want more friends, it's a problem. So napakinggan nyo, guys, the sound is really nice, crisp, and very balanced, no? I can say now when you're playing games on this one, definitely magugustuhan nyo, no? And speaking of gaming, naglaro tayo ng ilang games no dito sa phone na ito. And minaximize natin ang kanyang shoulder triggers na lumalabas dito, no? And by the way, guys, pag nilabas ko itong dalawang shoulder triggers, automatic lalabas ang game space mode. Ayos, diba? So, nilaro natin a couple of games no, here habang nakaupo tayo dito sa ating favorite na gaming chair. So, naglaro tayo a couple of titles dito. No? So, while playing the Call of Duty Mobile, guys, I can say na sobrang immersive ang experience nito. No? Snapdragon 8 Gen 1 definitely sobrang beast ang performance niya. No? And coupled with yung JBL na speakers nito, no? Giving you that super immersive sounds here, lalo na kung parang naglalakad yung kalaban mo, manilig mo siya. It's definitely an advantage sa yun, no? When you're, of course, sa battlefield, mas ano kaya, mas lamang ka pag narinig mo na maayos, no? From coming from the left, coming from the right. The sound is definitely very nice, no? On this K40 Gaming Edition. And of course, how can I forget na mention ng kanyang shoulder triggers? It's giving me definitely that experience na, I mean, better than yung mga air triggers, no? I know many of you are fans sa mga air triggers, no? But ako personally, I'm a fan of physical shoulder triggers, no? Giving me that, yung pag kiniklik mo, nafe-feel mo yung, ano, yung response. I mean, iba eh, ibang-iba. When you're playing no with shoulder triggers like the physical one no, and that's the advantage nitong K50 Gaming no, na well minana niya from the K40 Gaming. Playing other titles like Genshin Impact, Asphalt 9, and I can say guys that this is definitely one heck of a gaming device. Sobrang smooth na experience. So guys, nakita natin no, ang ganda ng placement nitong camera na to, and it really looks nice and more of a game centric no ang itsura ng camera na ito, no? It has a 64MP na main shooter, 8MP na ultra-wide lens, and 2MP macro lens. So, and at up front, meron siyang punch hole na camera, 20MP. No? So nilabas ko naman siya, no? Taking a quick some quick shots. I can say na okay naman siya. No? I wouldn't say na one of the best camera no? Itong phone na ito. This is mainly built for gaming. But for me, the shots from the front, from the back, is definitely okay, no? Hindi siya the best, but for a gaming device like this one, pwede na. So, one of the most impressive one is yung charging speed nito, guys. From, ano no, from 10% charging backup to 100, ang bilis siya natapos. Using 120 watts na GaN charger niya, no? 18 minutes, guys. 18 minutes tapos na mag-charge tong phone na to. Sobrang bilis, guys. Sobrang blazing fast ang ganyang charging, no? And, of course, you want to ask me no about yung battery endurance nitong phone ito. All I can say is that it wouldn't really last you for a whole day, okay? Since it's more of a power-hungry device. So definitely this one would consume a little bit more energy than usual, especially kung lalo ka on the go, lagi ka nag-gaming, I'm sure yung battery na maubos. I think around sa gitna pa lang ng ano no, tanghali pa lang, kailangan mo na mag-charge nitong phone na ito. So guys, what can I say about this gaming device? The Redmi K50 Gaming, and of course, it's a limited edition. This is the AMG Petronas edition. Rare na rare siya. I'm sure na you might want to get your hands on this one if you're given the chance. But there's also the regular edition nitong phone na ito. The K50 Gaming regular edition. It comes in several colors, no? Check it out sa official website ni Xiaomi. And I'm sure na this would be available sa Shandy Philippines and sa Shandy Masangkay. Check it out on the Facebook page that I posted on the description box below. Guys, what can I say about this gaming device? The Redmi K50 Gaming. Well, after all, it's a gaming device. So sabi ko sa guys, it's blazing fast. Ang ganda, ang sarap hawakan niya. Hindi siya mabigat. Unlike the Black Shark 4 Pro, which is 220 grams, ito, 210 grams lang siya. Overall, the experience is nice, the camera is nice, and I can say that this should be one of your daily driver that you should put inside your bucket list for 2022. And of course, guys, I'm not quite sure kung lalabas to sa global, but I'm sure hindi. Last year, si Redmi K40 Gaming lumabas siya sa India only as the Poco F3 GT. Here sa atin, hindi lumabas ang X3 GT, which is of course a spin-off ng K40 Pro. this time around, I hope this year, ilabas nila sa global. And so guys, if you like this video, don't forget to like, subscribe, and of course, click nyo ang bell icon para hindi nyo mamiss ang mga future videos ko dito sa aking channel. And so, ako pala si Richmond, and you're watching Gadget Sidekick! What's up?